You fill up my senses like a night in a forest, like a mountains in springtime, like a walk in the morning, like a storm in the
surprise. Josie and Tony's 50th anniversary.
Nice one. Beautiful. Do you reckon they know anything about it?
Not much more than that. Well, I know that about probably 20 years after they got married. Well, it wouldn't be that long, would it? And beautiful walk.
It's my grandparents' 50th wedding anniversary. It's very exciting because Mel and I are about to get married, and they are the perfect template for a long and happy marriage. So congratulations to Josie and Tony. We love you very much.
Now what's going on here?
I'm on you.
Yeah, I am.
Bridesmaid.
Can you tell me what we're doing here?
We've been Josie and Tony's wedding anniversary, 50 years.
Good. Are you looking forward to it?
Yeah, it should be fun. Looks like it's going to be a really good afternoon.
Don't let the sound of your own wheels drive you crazy.
So they'll get around and say g'day to everybody. There's going to be finger food, bars open, so help yourselves to a drink, and let's celebrate the day.
Yeah.
see, we've got plenty of substitutes.
Oh, God, we can have a substitute.
Your husband's coming.
Is he?
What?
Yeah, I'll film you though.
Oh, yes.
Nice.
Okay, guys, let's see.
I'm going.
If we can keep it quiet for a couple of minutes, I've got a bit to say, just enough, not too much. But firstly, we'd like to thank you for all attending, obviously. For Mary, Simi, myself, and obviously Andrew, these are the two most important people in our world. And we thank you for attending to show your appreciation and obviously your association to them. Some people here, right, I know have been there since the beginning. There's obviously family members from Mum's side that were there when Dad came into their world, and also vice versa. But there's other important families that when Mum and Dad established their lives or began to establish their lives in our family in Adelaide that were really important, like the Rockers and the Kennedys, etc. And then families like the Douglases when we moved as children who didn't know anyone in Melbourne from Adelaide to Melbourne. So, you know, everyone here is really important. Everyone has a link to Mum and Dad. And I was actually saying to Mary this morning that I think that everyone's got great parents and people that they know, etc. But in our case, I feel that we're extra lucky. I think that we've got two people who firstly love each other beyond belief. Nothing comes between Mum and Dad, and nothing has ever become between Mum and Dad. They've always been consolidated. Even us children have come between Mum and Dad. Mum and Dad have been this unit above the family and the line of humans that they've created. And so we're really, really lucky that they love each other so strongly, and that they imparted that love and that care on us. You know, on top of that, you know, I mean, I've been really lucky. I think we've been really lucky. Dad is one of the most intelligent people, probably the most intelligent person I've ever met. Not only smart, but practically intelligent. There's a massive difference between intelligence that's theoretical and practical intelligence. And then I add to that the wisdom of my mother. Our mother is easily the wisest person that I've ever come into contact with, and I've worked out where that comes from, because Mum's told me this story a number of times over the year, but you forget things. And Mum told me at a point in time, she's in Adelaide, Mum and Dad are struggling, they don't know anybody, money's really, really tight. I think Mum, at a point in time, the outgoings were greater than the incomings, and you were struggling to make ends meet. And Grandpa Savona, Mum's magnificent father, came over and spent some time. He used to spend his holidays in Adelaide with us at that point in time. Thank God, because without the Rockers or Grandpa, we'd never have any photos. Because the family had no money to even take a photo and get a photo to them. But Mum was beside herself, financially under stress, the mothers of two young children, because, you know, Mary, Andrew and myself were born less than 3 years apart. And Grandpa looked at Mum and he said something like, Mum said, I was hoping he had his arm around me, and she was hoping for one of those things, you know, I love you, sweetheart, everything's going well, you're doing a great job, how can I help, etc. And Grandpa said to Mum, and this is where the wisdom comes from, and she said, how are you, dearie? This is what Grandpa used to say to Mum, dearie. And she said, oh...
Exhausted
life stuff. And Grandpa said to her, well, dearie, this is what you wanted. You wanted marriage and you wanted to have children. This is life. And Mum's told me this probably 10 times over the course of my life. And absolutely, it's true, isn't it, Mum? That is what life is all about. You're going to either sit there and whinge about your circumstance or make stuff happen.
Just get on with it.
Yeah. Mum and Dad have always made stuff happen. With, in many cases, minimal, because there was nothing in our household really until I was in my mid-teens. when we were 10-year-old, 5-year-old, 12-year-old, there was nothing. Dad, I remember a pair of football boots that you bought for me, some vinyl Puma boots. Remember that? And our dog, Mitzi. Mitzi was a French poodle.
Oh, yeah.
She chewed the hell out of them one night.
Oh, no.
And these weren't hugely expensive, although they were hugely expensive for our household. We put tape on them, etc. I played the rest of the season in that pair of footy boots. But I appreciated that. And I
played very well.
And I appreciated the effort that Dad gave, that Mum and Dad gave, was so little, whatever they could to us. So we're blessed to have you as our parents.
Yeah,
I know that
yeah.
you're both blessed to have each other. I think that if they talk about yin and yang, which is one's this and one is this, then you two as a collective are this.
Oh.
And you've always been that way. To get through the stuff that you've had to get through, Mum and Dad. You know, and I know that I think about Andrew every day, so I can't imagine what it is for you guys. Spectacular. Spectacular. And we miss him, and Andrew's a part of this day. And this day is a surprise to you from Mary, Simi, Andrew and myself. Okay? We couldn't tell you, Mum, because we know that you wouldn't turn up. Because Mum hates being fussed over, Mum hates being the centre of attention, and Mum sees almost everything as a waste. Everyone's always under financial pressure, whether they are or they aren't. And so that's why we wanted to do this, Mum, because you guys have never really let us do anything. We've been invited to a million things. In celebration of your birthdays, of your lives, of your wedding, etc., of your marriage, but we've never been able to do it. You've never allowed us to do that, and we wanted to. We know that we've got many years left together, thank God. But we wanted to do this, and everyone's played their part in it, and we wanted to celebrate. You know, I think you guys make people feel better. I think that's why I think you make people feel better around you. I think you make people feel better about themselves around you. And I think that is an amazing quality. That is in our modern world, which is all about instant gratification and materialism, is quite an unbelievable thing. And I know, and I'm your son, but I know that I feel better when I'm around you guys.
We all do.
We all feel the same. We love you very, very, very much. And you guys have carved out a spectacular life together, and who would have thought a young woman from Malta with four siblings and no mother, whose father decides to try and give his family a better life without a wife and a mother, to emigrate to Australia, and then Dad and his family from Egypt. Now, so one from Malta, one from Egypt, they moved to Australia. Who would have ever thought they could actually meet each other?
Yeah.
So, you know, there's a miracle in relationships, etc., how that all works. And Mum and I were talking recently, it's about luck.
Destiny.
No, well, it is. It has to be about a destiny or something, doesn't it? Otherwise, how does it happen? And who am I if I'm not the child of these two people? Well, I don't exist. I might have been something else or someone else, but I don't exist as I am today. So, and we're all in the same boat. So, this is all about you guys, and it's about bloody time, and we love you so much, it is unbelievable, okay? And please enjoy the day, but you know, this is not just about today, this is how we feel about you guys all the time. Enjoy.
What about the box rating? Let me get a mention. Hey, Paul, what about the box rating? I'll take kids of it.
I remember the Volkswagen all the way from Adelaide to Melbourne. I remember starting to start Captain Dan. I remember you guys building
four kids of guys in the last room.
Yeah, remember you guys building the house at the back of the house.
Yeah.
Is it a photo or video?
She never shuts up. What's going on?
I know.
Tony,
came across, really elevated us beyond what we believe we are. But thank you for that. Wonderful, yeah. Wonderful words. I can't match. But I'm very, very well happy for being here today with all our beautiful kids who helped us to celebrate with all our friends. They put so much effort into it, there was not a hint not a hint of other people being involved. It was going to be a family restaurant get together. And here we are. We've got so many lovely people that have been so important in our life. Very, very important. We can go from Frank and Bob, Kathy and Heather. We Mahoney's. Without them, we wouldn't have been in Adelaide, and without them, we wouldn't have done well in Adelaide, which we did. And we're grateful to them, because then, of course, we got big because we had three children. It was a very, very hard life for Josie, especially. I used to take off in the morning at 6 o'clock in the morning, go to work, and after work I'd go to university and study, and then off I'd come home, and I'd get off at Jeb's Cross, and I had to walk. There's no bus service beyond Jeb's Cross, and I had to walk from Jeb's Cross to Baraka, where we lived, every time I went to the city and did studies, and it was very, very hard for Josie. She really had the children, three children, one after the other,
yeah.
2 1/4 years apart. She had to really bring them up on her own, very lonely, very lonely. But I never underestimated her job. She did magnificent. She's a beautiful lady. I couldn't wish her a better partner. I honestly did. And of course, when I first met Josie, you heard the story. It was all on Jacana Station,
yeah.
A train station. I met Josie, and she was very windy that day, and she paid for a ticket, got a ticket, and the wind blew.
I had the money to pay for my rail ticket, and it blew.
There's no way under the railway lines, and the train is coming. And this Josie's looking, and I jumped down on the rails, brought it up, and she said, she thought to herself later, she told me, oh, now he expects me to
sit down and talk to him.
So we sat across from each other on the train, and I was going to Mini Valley Races to meet Dad. But she hit my eye, and as far as I'm concerned, she's the greatest person ever that I could have possibly met. And I pursued her. I lost track of her, but I knew she's around Jacana somewhere. I kept going
he's
back
come
to Jacana.
For me.
And one day, well, I was horse riding with my cousin. We went past Jacana Station deliberately, and there was Josie waiting to catch a bus to go to work.
Right? I did chip yes. work.
And
it's almost like a story.
And so we built up from there, and showered her with presents, didn't I? Yeah. And her sisters used to.
I used to because sneak my them in.
Her dad was a bit.
Dad, you always told me that mum found you extraordinary. He's the builder of Australia's Cary Grant.
Oh, come on. She never told me that, ever. It's not true. I was more like, what's the play?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah. Anyhow, the thing is, we progressed from there, and we did some. We set up.
The rest is history. We have three children.
You want to cut it down?
No. I don't want to bore everybody.
Anyhow, with Baraka, we actually established a football club.
We did.
Baraka Football Club from scratch. Five or six people did that. And I was one of them. And we did a lot of. We even were the first junior club to actually build a licensed club right next to the oval where we used to play.
Excuse me, everyone. You know why we did this? We couldn't afford any other entertainment, could we? So
you
that was.
Over,
oh, well, I'll take that for me. So that used to be our entertainment. We used to go round door knocking.
Women, after a while, you know, you're cute. Off you go.
And we're getting our members and doing all of that sort of thing. It was a way of meeting people. And of course, we organised dinners. Yeah. We used to work in the canteen, take the kids to the football. And it was just a simple, beautiful, beautiful way of. Life, just getting to know people and without spending any money, because we didn't have any money to spend anyway, you know. Yeah. So, and it was part of the involvement, apart from the parish, of course, you know. But,
and then,
of course, because when I cooked, I used to use your whole grocery.
Oh,
one meal.
Alice said to me one day, she said, can I invite my boyfriend over for dinner?
How many guys can all the way from.
I know. And I said, yes, that's all right. And he was a chef or something. And so I think she used up my whole week's budget for that.
Oh,
my God, I family meal. and traded the soft drink bottles in to keep the family.
We did. Yeah, because when the family used to come in Adelaide, you have, if you return your bottles, you get some money back for them. And when my dad used to come and I'd buy lemonade, which was such a treat. I wish to go and trade the bottles in, just because that way it made the budget stretch. And God bless your mum, Terry. God bless your mum, Tony. She was just wonderful.
She was, wasn't she?
Not only that, she understood about life and she understood the struggle. She went through the struggles herself, and she never ever made us feel as if there was any shame in not having enough and just struggling, because the mortgage was the most important thing to pay in those days. Hold on to your house. So that used to get paid first, and whatever was left just went to whatever, you know. But can I just make a little dedication to Tony? Always thinks. Sorry,
we're all right over here.
Sorry, you've got to suffer. It won't be much longer, John. But
what about?
I just want to make a dedication to, you know, Tony, for being such a wonderful husband and such a wonderful father.
Yes.
He's always, and through all, Bob, you know how busy he was, going to work, going to uni, walking. I didn't see him until 11 o'clock. But whatever the kids were involved in, any sport whatsoever, he was always there for them. He, whatever the parish wanted, he was always there as well. Somehow he sort of found the time, and he's just been such a wonderful, caring, and he would do that for anybody. If any of you were in hospital, he doesn't drive, and he couldn't get there, he would go by this train, by that bus, by this, by that, by this. Nothing was ever too hard for him to go and visit the people that he really loved, you know. And then just from the bottom of my heart, I just want to say thank you, all of you that are here, every single one of you, I have borrowed from you. I don't know if you realise this. My grandchildren, I've learned so much from you. I've learned so much from my friends. So I've taken something from all of you without any of you realising that I've done this. Because that's what life's all about. And yes, we've done 50 years together, but it's like we've worked hard at it too. Nothing, so the little grandchildren don't look and say they've got such a wonderful, we've got a wonderful marriage. It takes work, but it's luck too. There's so much luck involved. I mean, I could have picked this man, and he could have turned out to be totally different.
And if I waited a couple of years, I could have picked him. Exactly. You know,
things change in life all the time. You know, because things change in life all the time, and you've got to change with it. You've got to adjust, and nothing is as smooth as it seems on the outside. But, you know, I always say you can fall out of love with someone, but don't fall out of respect. Once you fall out of respect, it's the most wonderful thing that you can have, because you respect someone, you'll respect them for life. It's because you respect someone, you trust them. But if without respect, you don't have that trust. And so from the bottom of my heart to my beautiful children, my wonderful grandchildren, and all of you, I honour you all today. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart for all turning up. I'm still in shock. So if I'm saying anything that I shouldn't be saying, please don't hold it against me. All right?
Finally, I believe that in these two bags, something that might belong to one.
She gave me a big lift here.
And then I'm going to put a video also
beyond
on
my capabilities.
I'll put that there.
This is not a virtual present.
Something for our 50 years together.
Tony,
it's only a little something.
I was going to get an oven. We need an oven.
You'll get the oven.
It's
not a very big oven.
For the dolls.
Beautiful lady that I know. I'm sorry, girl.
If
it doesn't fit, it can be extended.
Oh,
You better reciprocate, man.
It's a bit, grandchildren, there's a ring for all of you. When
I thought you were going to say there's a ring for
everybody.
All right, guys, that's the end of the four. I'm going to run a video of this run on wood. What are we going to sing?
Just begun to live, white lace and promises, a kiss for luck and we're on our way.
We've only begun
before the rising sun.
Place where there's room to grow,
and yet. yes, we've just begun.